I'm Hannah, and I'm 12, and I'm the first snowflake in the world.
It really was a concern as far as eventually telling my daughter her story and the frozen aspect of it.
The way we were going to explain this whole adoption to Hannah was to be honest from the get-go.
I remember when I was little, I was adopted as a seed and put into my mommy's tummy to grow.
Describing to Hannah what an embryo is and how, you know, I'm able to carry that child and how all of them don't make it through the thaw process, through the transfer process, and bringing them to term. So we did that with the seedlings and with the plants.
When I got a little older, the next piece was, it's an embryo. It's not a seed, it's a live human being that's being developed. Embryo adoption is where it's pretty much the first stage of a baby's development, but it's from a different person's genetics, and it's put into the womb of a mother, and they end up getting to carry that child and give birth to it themselves.
Embryo adoption never occurred to me either. You know, I thought we'd probably pursue traditional adoption.
I had a very strong desire to experience pregnancy. We wanted to do it in a way that we felt honored God.
When people can't have children, they kind of just go into the basic aspect of adoption, which is adopting from a country or an orphanage. But they never really know about embryo adoption, where you can actually have your own child instead of just adopting.
We were the first family to use this model of adopting embryos. It's been a total positive experience. Every now and then there'll be a negative story in the media. You know, why aren't we using these embryos for medical research purposes? But overall, just totally overwhelmingly positive story for us.
With us, it was just adoption 9 months prior to when you would maybe traditionally adopt, if you were adopting a newborn.
Well, I've gone to the White House about 4 times. I've met the president 2 times, and I was on TV for snowflake embryo adoption, and I was with President Bush at his first veto.
We went back, and Marlene was going to testify before Congress. You know, I thought, I didn't tell anybody, I just took a couple days off, and I thought this would fly under the radar until we walked into that room that it was held in and saw all the reporters, and I knew this was going to be big news. And then the next day, there's my picture holding Hannah in the New York Times. I had a friend who found out he had cancer and was going to be unable to father a child, and I suggested, why don't you adopt? And he says, I don't want to raise somebody else's kid. And I mean, I knew immediately, that's wrong. You're not raising somebody else's child. You adopt him, it's your kid. Same with embryo adoption. It's been nothing but great for us.
If people don't really know about snowflakes, they don't have the opportunity to have a child. And it's a huge opportunity because a lot of people have been waiting for this their whole life.
Embryo donation and adoption. Share the hope. Learn more at embryoadoption.org.